Same thing, look at I got to quit. But the Bible says when the Holy Ghost is in manifestation, they open their mouths and praise the Lord. Tell your neighbor, you got 20 more seconds to open your mouth all over this building and give God a praise from the fruit of your lips. Everybody open your mouth. In that room were no musicians.
No play.
No singers. They just got on one accord and began to praise God. I need everybody in this room to put it in your mind. Hallelujah. I need to put a hallelujah on my lips, a thank you, Jesus, on my lips. And all of us in here right now, let's get on one accord and begin to praise God right now. Everybody. Begin to give him glory right now. Everybody. Don't clap your hands, open your mouth. Don't clap your hands, open your mouth. Everybody in this room. Everybody in this room, open your mouth. Let's get on one accord, church. Don't do it quietly. Tell God how wonderful he is to you.
call, an altar call.
Somebody ought to feel better. I said somebody in here ought to feel better.
He may sing something.
I said somebody in here ought to feel better.
You can come in. Hold on.
Fill me up.
Hold on.
Till I overflow.
You get it.
I wanna run over. I wanna run over. Fill me up till I overflow. I wanna run over.
What key is that? A flat. All the mics are unmuted.
Lift your hands.
Till I
everybody, A flat. Soften.
Till I
the glory of the Lord is here. The Bible says in his presence is the fullness of joy, and at his right hand are pleasures forevermore. One thing you got to know from today, this joy and this power that you feel right now is not just limited to this building. But when the Holy Ghost is on the inside of you, you can feel this joy in your living room. You can feel this joy riding down the street. You can feel this joy on your job. Because this joy that we have, the world didn't give it to us, and the world cannot take it away. But the only way to receive this joy is to receive Jesus Christ. If you let him in your heart, he'll fill you afresh with his Holy Spirit so that you can live and move and breathe the joy of the Lord, so that he can give you the power to live for him, not just in here, but out there. I got a brother or sister in this place that says, Pastor, I want that joy. I want to give my heart and mind to Jesus. What must I do to be saved? Number one, you must believe that Jesus is Lord. You must believe that he died for you and died as you. That he who knew no sin became sin, that you may become the righteousness of God. Let me be very clear to say to you, brother and sister,
stay on the green.
This joy you can't buy it. It's all, the price has already been paid, because Jesus shed his blood that you may have this joy. If you're in this church and you say, Pastor, I've never confessed Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior, but I want to do it today. Or you are saved but don't have a church home, this is the place for you to go and grow in God. All you simply need to do is come out of that row and meet me right here by the stairs. I'm not going to question you. I'm not going to call you out. I'm not going to interrogate you, but our church is going to celebrate you for giving your life to the Lord Jesus Christ. If that's you and you want to give your heart to Jesus Christ today, just come out of that row and just meet me right here. Or you're saved, but you don't have a church on. You want to go and grow in fellowship. Come on. Jesus Christ is here to save you. Come on. Don't wait on the first person to move. You be the first person to move. The clergy are in every aisle awaiting your arrival just to welcome you. to welcome you into the body of Christ. Will there be one that will come and say, Pastor, it's me. I want to give my heart and mind to Jesus Christ. I want to do it today. I don't want to wait. I want to do it today. Who is it? Come on. God didn't send you in this church by accident. He sent you in here on purpose for you to hear this word that you may respond affirmatively. Come on, it's your time and turn. Empty your cup so that Christ can fill it. Your past is behind you. You got life ahead of you now. Come on. Church, somebody give God praise. Fill me up. Who else is it that says, Pastor, it's me. I want to give my life to the Lord Jesus. I want to do it today. Who else is it? Come on. In the balcony, I'm talking to you as well. Come on. Christ is here to save you. You don't have to leave out of this place without a relationship with Jesus. Come on. He's here to save you. I believe it's somebody else here. Everybody around you, are they saved? Do they have a church home? If they say no to any one of those questions, tell them, I'll walk with you. You ain't got to go by yourself. I'll stand with you. You don't have to go by yourself. I just want you to be sure that you will receive and open up your heart to receive Jesus Christ. Ask everybody around you. Ask them. Ask them. We want you to walk in the love of God. Praise for my sister coming. Welcome to the Lord Jesus Christ and welcome to the family of God. Right here, Minister Wilson will take you through the plan of salvation. Come on, church, give God praise for fill me up.
Yeah, I wanna.
I wanna feel. Somebody give God praise for his power, Lord. No, I said give God praise for his power and his glory. I said give God praise for his power and his glory. Church, it's giving time. Hallelujah. If you're in need of an envelope, you want to use an envelope, raise your hand. Raise your hand. In whatever section you are, raise your hand. I need you guys to cut the lights on so the ushers can see these hands go up. God bless you. If you need an envelope, raise your hand. The ushers are in every aisle, prepared to bring you an envelope. In the balcony as well, if you stand with the wall. Amen. Amen. God bless you.